Hello, Professor Stanzel. This is Kristen Madla, and today is Tuesday, July 23rd. And today I'll be starting the bacterial identification through functional media lab. And I'm basically going to be conducting a motility test. And I'm going to start by prepping the motility media tubes. So I have two motility test tubes right here. And one of them I have labeled E. coli. And the other one I have labeled S. epidermidis. And I'm basically going to transfer microbes into these two tubes using the E. coli agar plates and one for S. epidermidis agar plates that I prepped in a previous experiment. So again, I'm gonna mix it up and I'm going to prep the S. epidermidis motility test tube first. So I'm gonna put the E. coli aside. And I'm gonna start by taking the S. epidermidis motility test tube. And I'm gonna sterilize the lip of the tube using this flame. So I'm gonna unscrew the cap. And I'm gonna sterilize it. Okay, I'm gonna put this back just for a moment for safekeeping. And I'm gonna take the S. epidermidis agar plate. I'm gonna flip it over. And I'm gonna take a paper clip that I have straightened out and sanitized in rubbing alcohol, and I'm gonna tap it dry. And I'm gonna scrape colonies using this paper clip. Get every little square inch. Okay, so I'm gonna put the lid back on, over, and now I'm going to take my motility agar tube for S. epidermidis, and I'm going to stab the agar all the way down. And slowly bring it back up. Okay. And now I'm going to sterilize the lip of the tube using the flame again. Okay. And I'm going to put the cap back on. So now I'm going to prep the E. coli motility test tube, and I'm gonna repeat the exact same steps that I did with the S. epidermidis motility test tube, but this time I'm going to use a paper clip to collect cultures from my E. coli agar plate, and then I'm gonna transfer it into that tube. So once I do that, then I'm going to put both the motility test tubes into the incubation location for 48 hours. And before I do that, I'm also gonna take a picture as well so that I can have a before and after picture. Okay, so it's been 72 hours since I let these two motility tests incubate. So now I'm gonna talk about the test results for both. So starting first with the E. coli test agar. Now this particular tube only required 48 hours of incubation, and there's definitely a lot of growth in this tube. Now you can see where I did stab the agar. But what's interesting about the E. coli test tube is that the microbes have exceeded the stab line and are growing in other places in the tube. There's actually one place specifically right below the L and the I of the word coli that I wrote. You can actually see some growth. So this is definitely a sign that E. coli is motile. And it's what's amazing is if you look really close, is that you'll see a lot of like hair-like structures growing out of the stab line. So this is definitely a motile microbe. Now for S. epidermidis, this particular tube required an additional 24 hours of incubation time because there wasn't really much growth going on in the tube. But after that extra 24 hours, I did start to notice some signs of growth. Now, what's interesting about this tube is that even though there are signs of growth, most of it is contained within the stab line. And this is an indication that S. epidermidis is non-motile. So it means it can't move. Now, I know there was a little issue with my agar plate in a previous experiment, and I explained this before, was there was some mold that was growing on it. So I know that maybe the mold might have inhibited my results a little bit. So there is some minimal growth at the top, but it's very minimal compared to the growth that I see in the E. coli tube. So S. epidermidis is definitely non-motile. Okay, that concludes my lab. Thank you.